Hey, hello and welcome to Shadowrun Hong Kong. Today I'm going to talk to you about character creator and explain you enigmas of this aspect. In my opinion, you should start on easy because first mission in this game is hardest fight in the game. And I think that's good enough justification. So, I usually play as melee fighter, so I start with troll because it has bonus strength and bonus body, and that's what I need for melee. But this time, we're going to go with the boy. Oh, if you wanna have good template, you should select as auto. That way your template will be automatically matched with your portrait. From there, you can basically navigate yourself towards anybody who looks fucking remotely good and not half bald and not half Asian. Oh, I for example like this guy. And then make him white. And call it a day. We cannot call it a day, we have to fucking change it. For fuck's sake, is there any hairstyle that doesn't fucking... I hate this one. Okay, this one is acceptable. I mean, it's not perfectly fitting, but at least... And you start. You should start with body. In my opinion, 3 bodies minimum to finish, and you need to consider your focus. We're going to go range combat because I usually going melee. In my opinion, it's very good to start 4-4 or 4-4 here to have Overwatch. A melee Overwatch is naturally less effective, but you can use melee Overwatch with spells. Like, for example, this gives you mana bolt. So it's not useless to be good at melee. Also, you need charisma. I really like... for range cards, I like going Shadowrunner and Security. Security? Yes, Security. For melee character, I also like going security, but with gang or with academic. And here shaman specialization. I take cobra for +5 accuracy. +5 accuracy makes me more accurate with all weapons. Now, because I have range combat, I can now choose which of the range weapons I wanna specialize, and I wanna go for this. Level 2 pistol sounds good enough. And I can go here. All the way for level 4. And this is good enough character. This is range character. I normally do melee characters with heavy implication here. I usually end with 9 here. And I usually go for 8 here. Or 6. No, I usually go for 6. Because 6 gives you defense bonus from close combat. And give you cleave. For this arm, you have to put a lot of points. So, because you see, 6 give you this defense bonus, and give you cleave, and if you're going unarmed, give you armor stripping. For additional 8 from 6, when you have it, it will cost you like 7, 8, 7, 8, and 5, 6, 7, 8. This is a lot of points that you could fucking commit elsewhere. So even if your race expands your racial capabilities, it doesn't mean you will fucking finish it. It costs 17. This cost me 10. This 4 abilities cost me 10. The one ability, one point here costs 17 at the end. Anyway, I will cut it to the final combat from this level first and show you what's up. So we are back, mission hard landing. I promised you to skip you to the end of the chapter for final combat. And I'm going to show you this final combat. Okay, so this is very strategic right now, what I'm doing. You meet with these assholes and asking what the fuck. If you are approaching them, I stand in the open. You will have two bonus moves. These bonus moves are meant to be used for to take cover, but I summon something. Your most important goal is to stay in cover. I will take a suicidal approach and try to... not do anything useful. But yeah, any turn that you end without being in cover, you end being in the grave. Also nothing better than fucking elemental spirits, I'm telling you. I mean, they seem powerful. This is Isabella, and naturally, instead of fucking letting me move with her, game is doing stupid charades. Three AP move. Naturalnie. Gobbles, it will be ultra beneficial. If you could heal our dying companion, can you arrest him, please? 91% miss. Okay. No, it's also a good answer in this situation. You don't have to be so fucking weird about this. Who is fucking bothering me? I literally turn off Discord, so nobody fucking bother me with garbage. And what? They want garbage on my fucking phone now. I'm not fucking answering now. What? Why it took fucking so much damage, please stop. Okay, cover. Tiny, good, good work. Okay. You might be fucking wondering what the fuck. So I'm openly ignoring half of the enemies. Because yes. Because I can. Why and how? Duncan, you will need to arrest this person. So Duncan have unique ability that allow him to arrest people. Like this bad guy. Okay, I am in range. Okay, perfect. So I move out. Seriously? Holy shit, he's alive. Not for the lack of trying. Fuckers. So yeah, this mission is relatively hard, if I can say so. I mean, you can fight them and even fucking win, but why? So, first, like, parts of the game will not exactly show you the build. I'm just trying to show you that build works and can finish you the first mission. There is a lot of fucking talking and like establishing character at the very beginning, so you don't exactly do much of action. I mean, your technique is start, but this hard landing start is a fucking bullshit. Dragonfall have much better opening.